Good afternoon guys, MC Procrastinator here for our 2 minute video as part of a 2 minute series. If you don't know what 2 minute series is, check the video link below and you'll find out all about it. Topic of today, KTM RC390 and the KTM 390 Duke. So before I go into these motorcycles, let me just talk about the KTM brand in general, give you a little bit of an idea about what the KTM brand is, where it's going, kind of a little bit of history about it and where it kind of fits in relationship to size regards other motorcycle brands such as Honda, Yamaha, Suzuki, etc. So let's first start by saying in 2012 the KTM brand had a 14% stake by a company called Bajaj Auto. They are a motorcycle brand manufacturer production in India and they had a 14% stake. Now in 2012, the interesting thing about this year is they jumped that stake from 40% up to 47%, which gave KTM a huge influx of funds to be able to develop, of course, things like their KTM RC390, 390 Duke, and their 200 RC125, etc. And of course, expand out their market share with the other brands. But importantly, what it also did was, because the Bajaj Auto were actually a motorcycle production company, they offered the resources and the manufacturing capability in-house in India on their production lines to be able to produce a very low cost yet high quality RC390, RC200, etc., etc., in India. Now, because obviously India is an establishing country when it comes to the quality that can sometimes come out of there, so KTM, being an Austrian company, what they decided to do was bring their quality assurance in-house. All the vehicles were shipped over to Austria to be able to be inspected, to make sure that they passed quality assurance, and then rolled out worldwide. Now, in 2015, and I'll put some links in below that back up these statistics, in 2015, KTM was actually recognized as the fastest growing motorcycle company in the world. I'll put the links in below that will back up some of the statements. In 2015, they sold 180,800 or so units, which generated a revenue of over $1 billion, which was absolutely amazing for a company of this size. Now, to put this in perspective on other motorcycle brands, Yamaha, they actually sold 6 million motorcycles in 2016, and Honda sold 16 million motorcycles in 2016. And to put that in perspective of revenue, we're talking trillions of dollars versus millions of dollars. But what's really, really important here, right? In Honda's example, a lot of those units were scooters, okay? So scooters, but more importantly, in the Asian market, right? When we look at what the KTM RC390 is and the Duke is, those lower level entry model bikes. Now in India alone, in 1 year, right, between 2015 and 2016, the sales of KTM, those specific models, rose 109% in 1 year. So the key thing here is, when we recognize Honda, Yamaha, that a huge portion, in fact, three quarters of what Honda sold were in Asian markets, it shows you that the power of India markets, Asia markets, will really help grow KTM to an exponential level. So let's talk about the RC390 and the KTM Duke. A fantastic looking bike for number one. It's 154 kilograms dry. It actually makes the bike super light. And unfortunately that can have a bit of a detrimental effect in high winds, such as in New Zealand, we got really high winds an awful lot of the time, but it also contributes towards great fuel efficiency. I believe it's 4.5 litres for every 100K. It's got a 10 litre tank, and the performance of the bike is actually fantastic, because not only is it 44 horsepower, but it can actually accelerate from 0 to 100 kilometres an hour in less than 6 seconds, so that's pretty amazing. It's also got the reassurance, got some safety features on it, you've got ABS, and I think all round the package, the bike is just a fantastic, well-rounded bike that if I was an entry-level buyer, I would definitely buy one. I guess my question would it be the RC390 or the KTM Duke? So anyway, jumping into 2017, what are some of the changes that are coming around from the KTM? Well, they're basically doing a couple of things. They're changing the whole throttle system into a fly-by-wire system. They reckon they'll get more fuel efficiency, better throttle response from that, I will say, for anybody that's never used a fly-by-wire throttle system before, it definitely does take a little bit of getting used to, and hopefully they'll get that right on first release instead of having to release ECU updates to be able to sort of fine-tune that a bit for smoothness. So hopefully they get that right. But what they're also doing is they're putting in a power-controlled slipper clutch, and they're changing the exhaust to a side mount. So that's really it with regards to KTM. It'll be really interesting to see where they go now with those entry-level bikes. And if you've seen my KTM RC8 video, I really want them to bring in another big bike to replace the RC8. They've got the KTM Duke, but I really want that sports bike back again. So look guys, for now, there's some information about the KTM brand, the RC390 and the Duke. Hopefully that helps you. For now, MC Procrastinator out.